From the importance of sleep to the mysteries of the universe, stay tuned to number one to find out the most wild findings in science. Number 10, the length of our DNA. Let's talk about the DNA that is within our bodies, okay? The DNA that humans are comprised of is what truly makes us, us. Without our DNA being exactly what it is, we literally wouldn't be human. And it's not a stretch to say that our body is comprised of DNA on virtually every level that matters. But that begs the question, just how long would our DNA be if we connected it into a single line? I personally love these questions, and the answer to this one is particularly epic. Because our bodies are so full of DNA, if you were to somehow connect them all together, even in the small state that they're in, you would be able to go from the Sun to Pluto and back 17 times. Now, to be clear, there is a small catch to this. You would have to unfold the DNA so that it's in its longest form, but even without that, it's a pretty long distance. And the reason for this is that our DNA is within just about every single cell of our body, and there's 37 trillion cells in the human body, and the DNA, when uncoiled, is about 5 centimeters long, so you do the math. I know this sounds extremely far-fetched, and I'm not a mathematician, but many scientists have confirmed this to be approximately true, depending upon the size of the person and the location of Pluto in its orbit. Either way, makes you appreciate DNA even more, huh? Number 9. Eating your own brain. Don't worry, I'm not talking about zombies being real, though let's be honest, it's only a matter of time. I'm actually talking about a chemical process that happens in your brain when certain requirements aren't met. What requirements, you ask? Easy. Getting enough sleep. We all know, or at the very least should know, about the importance of sleep. It's how our body and mind unwinds after a long day of activities, regardless of what they are. And when it comes to sleep, your brain is one of the biggest beneficiaries. When you sleep, your brain cleans away some of the negative gunk that fills it during the day, as your brain produces a lot of things to make your body work. But when you don't get enough sleep, the brain works so hard to clean out the debris that it will actually go and clear out the parts that you really do need, meaning that your body will go and eat your brain. Now, before you start panicking about getting enough sleep, it's not something that happens if you've only had 6 hours of sleep instead of 8. It's something that your brain does when it's fully sleep deprived. So as long as you get a decent night's sleep, your brain will be fine. At least until the zombies come. Number 8. Scientists weren't always scientists. Before we talk about the history of science, take a moment to like this video and join the Zero to Hero community by using the buttons below. The modern world we live in today is one very much dedicated to the sciences that help comprise our world. Biology, astrology, geology, and many more. Science is everywhere, and we learn it, and study it, and try to understand the things that we just don't know about at present. But there was a time when none of that mattered, also known as the age before science, or more specifically, the age before science was even a word. The 17th century was when the terms scientist and science were officially recognized, so to many, the ideas that they were proposing weren't an act of rational thought and fact, but of blasphemy. Because, as a wise man once said, anything that can't be explained is God. Referring to how sometimes irrational beliefs in a deity can lead to harsh judgment of those who don't believe the same way. So this begs the question, what were they called if they weren't called scientists? Well, they were called natural philosophers, and that wording is key. Natural obviously refers to the world around them, but philosophers refer to people who have a belief in something or point of view, not something based in fact. And many, like Galileo and Copernicus, were condemned by the Catholic Church, who was the dominant religion during their time, because of their beliefs, even though they were eventually proven right. Number 7. Spaghettification. Yes, that is a real word, and it refers to one of the most insane natural phenomenon in the universe itself, black holes. Black holes themselves are a phenomenon caused by a collapsing star, where the gravity is so intense from its collapse that it folds in on itself in such a way that it makes the gravity even stronger. So much so that not even light can escape it. For the record, those sci-fi movies and shows where you see the epic black hole, yeah, they're not real. But anyway, when something gets too close to the black hole, they undergo spaghettification, where they are literally stretched into oblivion. But to your naked eye, you won't see this happening unless it's happening to another star. There are points in the universe where a black hole exists next to a star, and the star will slowly be stretched into the black hole via a jet of plasma. So in a way, the black hole is unwinding the star and then absorbing it into itself. Number 6. You're covered in bacteria. Look, there's bacteria on you. Quick, go wash your hands. No, you missed. It's right there. And there, and there, and there, and there. Get the picture? While it is true that you should wash your hands and body often to help get rid of all the bacteria that you've collected during the day, the fact of the matter is, you won't ever get rid of it all. That's because your body is completely covered in bacteria from head to toe, and that's never gonna change. But there's no need to panic just yet. Just like there are good cells and bad cells in your body, so too are there good bacteria and bad bacteria. In fact, there are 10 times more bacteria cells in your body than there are regular cells. But again, don't panic just yet. This bacteria is crucial in helping your body function at a high level. Certain types of bacteria in your gut, for example, help you stay immune to certain diseases and sicknesses, while others go and break down the food that you eat in order to give you the nutrients and energy that you need to live. By all means, still try and get rid of all the bacteria on you, but don't hate all of them. Some bacteria keeps you alive. Number 5. Extinction level events. When you hear the word extinction, you know what it means. It truly means the end of a species. No other like it living on Earth. The most popular thing you can likely think of is the dinosaurs, which were potentially made extinct by a meteor, but there are many other theories on that matter. Or you think of the Ice Age creatures who passed after the world warmed up again. These are what you call extinction level events. And it's easy to think that there have only been two during the entire lifespan of Earth, but there's been a lot more. And no, the first one wasn't the asteroid or meteor that may have taken out the dinosaurs. Many happened before that, in fact. Hilariously, one of the greatest extinction level events came when microorganisms started pumping oxygen into the atmosphere. This was good for life eventually, as that's what we breathe. But back then, the pure oxygen almost took out all life forms. There have been other extinction level events that wiped out almost all of the creatures of the ocean and took out enough of the creatures on land to lead to the arrival of the dinosaurs. The point is, the Earth has dodged many end-of-life events in the past, and who knows when the next one will come. Number 4. Lightning is way too powerful. If there's one thing that humans love to do, it's try and harness power of nature for themselves. We can make our own water pure. We can start fires. We can use ice to our advantage and so forth. Another obvious one is that we can harness the power of electricity, which is something that comes from lightning. The catch, though, is that although we are able to generate our own electricity and create our own ways to store that energy, the raw power of a single lightning bolt is far greater than anything that humanity can accomplish, even in the modern age. There's 1 billion joules of energy in a single lightning strike, which makes it a miracle of sorts if you're able to get struck by one and survive. Anyway, we have electric generators that can do a couple hundred thousand joules, but nothing can come even close to the billion in a single lightning strike. So do yourself a favor, don't mess with lightning. It will mess you up. Number 3. A cat always lands on its feet. We always say this line because cats rarely seem to fall in an awkward way like humans or dogs sometimes do. But have you ever thought about whether or not it's true? Well, guess what? It is. And it all has to do with the bodies of the cats. Obviously, a cat can be held in a way as to where all 4 feet are pointed face up, but then if you were to drop them, and I highly recommend that you do not try this at home, you'll find that their bodies rotate when they fall so that they spin around and thus land on their feet. And the best part is that cats do this instinctively, proving that they're quite aware that they should be landing on their feet every time. Pretty neat, huh? Number 2. Around the world in a lifetime. How many of you want to travel the world? You know, go on a grand adventure and see all the sights? Well, the funny thing is, in the average lifetime, you actually walk the distance it would take to go around the world 5 times over. At first, this may seem odd, but you need to think about this in the grand scale of your life. On average, an active person will take about 7,500 steps a day. Now times that by 365 days in a year, and I'm guessing that you might live to, say, around 80? That would give you 216,262,500 steps in your lifetime. That is a lot. And if you convert that into miles, that's around 110,000. 5 times what it would take for you to walk around the Earth at once. And you thought you didn't exercise enough. Number 1. We still don't know everything. One of the things that teachers in high school and college will infer to you is that our knowledge of the world is great and expansive. And to a degree it is, but one of the truly wild things about science is that we still don't know everything that's going on out there in the world today. It may seem like we know a lot, but honestly, we don't. For proof of this, look no further than the animals of our world. We're still discovering new species of animals that have been around the Earth for thousands of years. And in the depths of the ocean, we don't even know a large majority of what lives down there, especially in areas like the Mariana Trench. Heading up to space, the universe is still a constant mystery, including the question of, are we alone in the universe? So while it's important to be knowledgeable, also acknowledge that we have a long way to go before we're all-knowing. What is your favorite part about science? Let us know in the comments below and take care.